Hi friends, this is Gundala Reddy Raghavendra, cleared civil service examination with All India rank 180 in civil services 2018. I cleared this exam in my last attempt. I have given 5 mains, 3 interviews. Finally, I am with IPS, Indian Police Service. Friends, most important element which is required for this exam is perseverance and hard work and determination, of course. See, in this my journey, I have given my first prelims in 2011. After that, I took a small gap of 2 years, worked in a software firm and resigned in 2014. From 2014 onwards, I have started giving again this exam. Finally, I got rank in 2019. Patience is one of the most important ingredient in this exam also. In this 3 stages of UPSC exam, like prelims, mains and interview, I think mains is the heart of this exam. Mains, with the help of mains, you can get good rank, even though if you do not perform well in interview also. But some people worried about prelims itself. Being cleared preliminary examination 5 times, I have some of the techniques and tips to clear this exam, to clear preliminary examination with smart work. Having said that, reading basic NCERT books and for Lakshmikant Polity and Current Affairs, Hindu or Indian Express, the preliminary requires some smart approach to clear this exam. Let me illustrate with analysis. After reading basic NCERT books and standard books in preliminary examination, one should see UPSC previous year question papers to get to know where UPSC is concentrating, number one. Number two, if you don't know any question in UPSC preliminary examination, how to go about it. Further, you need to solve last 40 years of UPSC question papers starting from 1979 to 2019, whereby you will get to know where UPSC is focusing on it. Number two, have a glance of UPSC papers of the current year. For example, if you are going to write in 2020, see where UPSC is focusing on that year, because already UPSC is asking, UPSC conducted CDS, NDA or other exams in 2020. So you will get to know where exactly UPSC is now focusing on it. It means focus on current year UPSC papers. Number three is, see, if you are appearing this exam first time or second time, even fifth time, sixth time also, nobody knows more than 50 questions in UPSC preliminary examination. Remaining 50 questions, you should attempt with your smart work. That smart work comes by practicing more number of question papers. Practice more number of question papers. And read questions very carefully in preliminary examination. Sometimes by oversight, you will not be able to distinguish between incorrect and not correct. Or maybe the keywords like not, all, only, or sometimes some of the things like this. Means my intention is, please be careful while reading the questions. The keywords matters a lot in preliminary examination. By having this smart work, you should secure minimum 110 plus in preliminary examination. Because post preliminary, the days are very, very important rather than these days. You should not worry about what should be my cutoff. You should not be in this cutoff syndrome. Rather, you should worry about how to start mains preparation. That lies the key there. So, you should secure minimum 110 plus in preliminary examination. If you are going to eliminate one of the options in preliminary examination, then go for it. And attempt as many questions as possible and get the dividends. This is about preliminary examination. See, those days after June 2nd, this day June 2nd to your mains, these days are very, very precious. You should use these precious days for mains answer writing rather than discussing about cutoff. Let me start with mains preparation. Mains preparation. In optional plays very, very important role in mains. Optional will make you help good getting good rank or may break your chances also. For example, I got good marks of 318 in sociology, which helped me to get a good rank of 180. That's why your preparation should be, at least you should concentrate more than 45% to your optional and 55% to your GS and SA. Optional, you should join any good test series and you should practice at least one answer per day during your post prelims to your mains examination. Answer writing plays very, very important role in optional. And if you take my optional sociology, especially the candidates who are going to take sociology as an optional, friends, don't distinguish between paper 1 and paper 2. See, nowadays UPSC is asking more about your application part of sociology, not about in-depth understanding of particular topic. For that, you need to interrelate between your newspaper articles with your syllabus. And also, try to draw simple diagrams in sociology and link with government programs. Link with government programs and important social changes which are going to take place in our society. And one more thing is, use your language in sociology particularly very lucid. Don't use too many jargons in sociology paper. Having said with optional, let me go for GS as well as SA. If you see 2018 SA paper, one of the most important changes have happened in 2018 is, in one complete section, they have asked about philosophical essays. Philosophy essays. And in section A, some of the essays are philosophy plus issue based. It means you should be thorough about philosophy essays also. Then how to go about philosophical essays? You should go about philosophical essays by touching various dimensions like society, social, political, historical, and with examples. Examples are most important in philosophical essays. Let me illustrate with one essay in 2018. In 2018, they have asked one essay called Customary Morality Cannot Be Guide to Modern Values, Modernity. The topic is like this: Customary Morality Cannot Be Guide to Modernity. I have started this essay, and one more thing in philosophical essays and any essays, start with good intro, good conclusion. These are the heart of your essay. Introduction and conclusions, these are very, very important. It's like heart of this essay. It doesn't mean that your body should not be wrong, should not be that much good. Means your body, if you have little here and there, it is okay for your inner body section. But if you are not good at intro and conclusion, you will not get good marks. In this essay of Customary Morality Cannot Be Guide to Modernity, I have started this essay with two important verdicts. One is Shabarimala verdict, where woman entry is not allowed. Second is Section 377, where it has been decriminalized. Homosexuality has been decriminalized. These verdicts indicates that customary morality cannot be guide to modern values. Then In next paragraph, I have started my essay like this. In this essay, we are going to narrate what is customary morality, why customary morality cannot be guide to modernity. Then third one is modernity is a panacea? And finally, what is happiness of happy society? It means I have agreed this statement, I have contradicted this statement, and finally, I am giving a hope to society. What is happiness, happy in society? And one more important thing in philosophical essay, as I said earlier, examples are the most important. Like customary morality, sati is an example for customary morality. Then untouchability is an example for customary morality. Then what is modernity? Modernity is about rationality. Your consumerism, your individualism is modernity. Finally, we need to take positive values of both customary morality as well as modernity. And in case of issue-based topics like education, women, or any other social issues topic, try to start with anecdote or any breakthrough important news, and try to incorporate facts also. Facts, quotes, interesting examples, best practices, you should incorporate this kind of essays. And your conclusion should be optimistic. And see, there are three important things you need to follow to get good marks in mains. See, your essay, your optional, and your ethics paper. This is called literally golden triangle for your main success. Your essay should be strong, you should get at least 130 plus, your optional at least 300 plus, in ethics at least 110 plus. Having said about essay preparation, let me talk about your general studies preparation. See, in general studies, we have four papers. GS 1, 2, 3, 4. And no need to distinguish it is GS 1 paper, GS 2 paper. Sometimes the questions from GS 3 they are asking in GS 1, GS 4 they are asking GS 2. So don't go for a blind distinguish between all these papers. For example, they have asked Juno mission in paper 1 or IRNSS in paper 1. Okay. In my opinion, in mains, 50% is your content, and 50% means 60% is your content plays very important role, and 40% is presentation. Presentation is the most important in your mains preparation. Mains answer writing, in fact. Let me go by each and every paper. GS1. In GS1, we have broadly there are three sections. Geography, history, and society. If you see the trends of last few years, society plays very important role. Approximately, you are getting 90 plus marks from society. And geography and history covers remaining portion of the question. In case of geography questions, try to draw a diagram, like simple India map where you can locate the probable places and other things. And history, in case of history, at least link history with current society. How current society has to learn lessons from history. And in society, try to use some sociological jargons, little jargons, like gender empowerment, globalization, Sanskritization. Okay, then social change, social trust, social empowerment, so that examiner will feel the flavor of sociology, something, not full sociology, at least you should be able to distinguish some of the answer with sociology. Further, you should read some basic NCERT books of 11th and 12th standards. In history also, already these two portions, geography and history, you have read in preliminary preparation. You have to read new only world history. Then society part already I told You should read 11th class and 12th class with supplementation with current affairs or newspapers. Okay. And as I already told, don't distinguish GS1 with other papers. Sometimes the questions may be repeated. Questions may come from GS2 and GS3 from in GS1 section. So I told you IRNS is one question, and second one is they have asked about policy convergence and important question, other questions. Then go to GS paper 2. In GS paper 2, we have broadly there are three sections. One is polity and governance, second one is social justice, third one is international relations. In polity and governance, if you see last 2 years trends, they are asking again conventional part. For instance, election commission, estimate committee and financial emergency, like they are going like back to basics. So please don't forget to revise basics again in mains. Apart from that, they are asking application part of questions like EVMs or policy, the policy paralysis type of questions. Okay, and please remember the articles. For example, you are writing election commission, which article in our constitution is mentioning about election commission, CAG and other things. Then comes to social use. And one more thing here, in polity and governance, the vocabulary is very, very important. Like governance, water governance, good governance, accountability, responsibility, transparency. Try to use Prime Minister Modi's Twitter statements. For instance, according to Prime Minister Modi, what is good governance? Good governance is nothing but art. Art means accountability, responsibility and transparency. Try to use simple diagrams. This will make a huge difference in mains answer writing. Please use Prime Minister statements, President statements in your answer. Then comes to my dear friends about social justice. Social justice, try to read Yojanas for this section. There are Yojanas for education, there is Yojana for health, there is Yojana for self-help group movement. All the topics which are mentioned in the social justice, they are mentioned in Yojanas. Please try to read Yojana. Then international relations. International relation, try to focus on current developments, not static issues. They will not ask what is write about India-Pakistan relations from starting from 1947. No. They will ask particular issue like Kartarpur corridor. How Kartarpur corridor is a breakthrough in India-Pakistan relations. Focus on specific questions in international relations and use simple diagrams. And use simple diagrams to illustrate international relations. And international relations also, you know, there are keywords to use in our answer like soft power, hard power, strategic convergence. Maintain separate notebook to have keywords for every paper. Paper 1, paper 2, paper 3, paper 4. Keywords for each and every paper. And GS2 plays very, very important role in our mains. Because GS2 will help you to get minimum, if you perform decently, it will award you minimum 110 plus marks in this exam. Let me go about GS3, General Studies, paper 3. GS3 also more of objective type of paper, more scientific, because economy is involved. GS3 contains economic section, then is disaster management, then third one is internal security, okay. Finally, science and technology and environment. For economy section and more about under GST, one more important thing is try to write facts in your answer. Okay, where you will get the facts? You will get those facts from economic survey. From economic survey. Try to read at least last 3 years of economic survey, especially volume 1. And recently, Niti Aayog released one document, Project India at the Rate of 75. Please, this is the most important document for economy section. Niti Aayog book, India at the Rate of 75. Then there are topics like food processing, land reforms. Try to read in Murnal website. And of course, Yojana also, one good read for economy. Then comes to disaster management. Disaster management, there is Yojana on disaster management. Try to have a glance on NDMA website, National Disaster Management Authority, and use simple diagrams. And internal security, again internal security, there are two parts. One is current internal security, second is static internal security. Read any book on current static internal security and try to relate with the current developments. Then finally, S&T environment. This, if you see 2018 paper, they have asked environment, two, three questions from environment also. Like wetlands, they have asked from environment. Biodiversity Act, they have asked environment. Now, it means the significance of environment increases in mains too. As environment plays important role in prelims also. Now it is having its role in mains too. And in S&T, try to focus on basic technologies like nanotechnologies, biotechnology, nuclear technology, and relate with the current affairs. And trust me, if you perform very well, you will get minimum 120 plus marks in economy, GS paper 3 section. Then finally, GS paper 4 section. GS paper 4 section. GS paper 4 ethics. The paper, as I already told you, in this golden triangle of ethics, essay, and optional. Ethics also increase your chance of getting selection in this exam. Basic purpose of ethics is to change human attitude. Please try to focus in every question about human attitude. It is not, this paper is not about administration or law. It's basically about human change in human values, human attitude. Try to fix on human attitude. And whenever you are going to write this exam, this ethics paper, think that you are an administrator and think that perspective, then you will get good answer. In ethics, my strategy is simple. There are three mantras for ethics. First, you have to be clear on your basics. You should have clear-cut definitions on the terminology in ethics. What is compassion? What is probity? What is integrity and others? What is the difference between conflict of interest and ethical dilemmas? Basics must be clear. Second important thing is examples play very, very important in ethics. Each and every concept should be backed with example. For example, you are going to write compassion, you should have back of your mind, you should have some examples. What is the example for compassion? Whether it is in your personal life or any important personality's life. Okay? Examples are very, very important. And finally, case studies section. Case studies are the most important in ethics. Approximately every year they are asking 6 case studies. Each carries 20 marks, means 120 marks. There are fair chance of getting more than 60 plus marks in ethics case studies. My advice is try to read the question in ethics, whether they are asking what are the courses of action or what are the options are available. Please try to read the case study question, the question asked mentioned in the case study, number one. Number two is, what are the ethical dilemmas present in the case study? And number three in the case study is, what is way forward? For example, the same incident happen in future, what is your way forward? What, how will going to prevent in the future? These three plays very, very important in case study section 2. My little GS paper 4 is, first attempt case study sections, then go for theory section. Because when the time is approaching, when the time is moving, if you are left with 10 minutes or 5 minutes, it is easier to attempt in case theory section, but it is very, very difficult to attempt case study section because you have to read the entire case. Okay. So this is about GS paper 4 section, my dear. Let me summarize what I discussed in mains preparation. Mains preparation, number one, your answer writing is most important. Answer writing include your presentation and content. Number two is, don't distinguish this is paper 1, this is paper 2, this is paper 3, this is paper 4. Don't distinguish. Do not distinguish it. Number three is, please make your own notes for each and every paper. If you see mains timetable schedule, you will not get break, you will not get time to go for reading of entire your notes. Make short notes, it will help you. Short notes, very, very important. Short notes of your own. Number four is, try to draw diagrams, flow charts beforehand. It will help you to get good marks in mains. This is about mains, my dear friends. Then finally, I will moving on interview section, final stage of this exam. As you know, interview also plays very, very important segment in this exam. It carries 275 marks. In this, DAF, detailed analysis framework, detailed application form. Detailed application form plays very, very important in your interview. You should write every word in detailed application form with honesty and integrity. Otherwise, if interviewers are going to understand this guy is bluffing or this guy is pretending as honest, they will award very, very less marks. Then your chance of getting selection will be ruined here. My sincere advice is, please fill detailed application form with honesty and integrity. Number two is, form small groups for your interview preparation. Form a group, the people who are coming from your home state or the form group with who are having a similar educational background or work experience, and try to discuss with them. One more thing in my interview is, they will not check your content, how much content this person is having, rather the presentation, how confident you are. The confidence plays very, very important. Confidence plays very, very important in interview preparation. And start your interview preparation as early as after your mains examination. Take 10 to 15 days of break, then start immediately your interview preparation. This is about, friends, about how to prepare this exam. On the outset of it, I want to give little advice who are appearing for this exam. See, in this exam, there is element of subjectivity in the prelims, mains or interview. Don't be disheartened when you did not clear this exam in first attempt or second attempt. Be patient. As element of subjectivity involves in this exam, it will take 1 year or 2 years, maybe 3 years. In my case, I got in my last attempt. See, success will be assured, but it may be delayed. Who knows it? You will get in first attempt or second attempt. But don't be disheartened, friends, please. And there are three important mantras I will tell. Dedication, determination, and discipline. Discipline is very, very important. Persistence in your preparation. Be faithful. Be having faith in yourself. Yes, you will clear this exam very, because you did not require IITs and IIM background to clear this exam. I am coming from a normal engineering college. I cleared this exam. It means everyone will clear this exam. The only thing required is the faith in yourself. Second is patience. Patience is the most important, my dear friends. Then, see, after getting success in this exam, now I'm enjoying enormous rewards. Rewards are enormous in this exam. Apart from social service, anyway, we are coming to this platform for social service. But apart from social platform, you will get enormous rewards, which will motivate you consistently. So, all the best, and wish you. My sincere advice is, please be honest in your preparation. Definitely you will get rewards. All the very best who are preparing for this exam in coming years. Thank you so much. Thank you.